Welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to create this simple editable text effect in Adobe Illustrator. In previous videos, I've created an editable text effect with a neon style which is a bit longer and more complicated, and now I'm going to show you an editable text effect that's simpler and easier to create. It only requires two fill layers and one stroke layer, and we only need to add one effect. Okay, let's get started. First, create a new document with a size of 1920 by 1080 pixels, with RGB color mode. Before we move on to creating this simple editable text effect, I want to add this palette to the swatches panel to make it easier for us to work with this text effect. I've prepared a download link for the color palette I'll be using in this tutorial. Besides that, I have also prepared a download link for the iFile from this tutorial if you want it. Okay, let's go back to the color palette. I have prepared two color groups. The first is a group of flat colors for the text, and two gradient colors for the background. First, select all these flat colors. After that, open the swatches panel. And click Add, New Color Group. You can give it any name you want, and click OK. In that way, these three colors have been added to the swatches in one group automatically. For these two gradient colors, we don't need to add them to the swatches, because these two gradients are only for background colors. You'll see in a moment why the gradient color for this background doesn't need to be added to the swatches. Now we have these three colors in the swatches. Then we can continue to create the editable text effect. The first step that we will do now is create the background. Create a rectangle the same size as the artboard using the rectangle tool in the toolbar. This rectangle is what we will use as the background. And to give it color we just use the eyedropper tool in the toolbar over here. Then pick a gradient color which is blue in the palette that I have prepared. The download link for this color palette is in the description. Did you see it? This is why I don't need to add these two gradients to the swatches panel, because it will be easier for us if we just use the eyedropper tool instead of adding them to the swatches. Next, open the gradient panel to modify this gradient a bit. In this gradient panel we only need to change the gradient angle to 45 degrees, and that's all we need to do with this gradient. Next, I'm gonna lock this background. To lock it we need to go to the object menu. Lock. Selection. So that in this way we don't have to worry about selecting it by accident, so we can focus on working on the text effect only. Okay, now it's time for us to create the text effect. Create the text using the text tool in the toolbar. Type any text you want. Resize it first by 195 points. For the font I chose Montserrat Black Italic. You can use any font as long as the font type is bold. Place it in the center of the artboard, you can use the align tool. Wait a minute, I almost forgot something, we should set the tracking on this character first, so that the effect that we will give to this text will not intersect each other. Open the character panel in the control panel overview, over here. And just set the tracking to 200. And reposition this text in the middle of the artboard. The next step, is we gonna add some effects to this text. First, open the appearance panel. If you don't find the appearance panel in your collapsed panel, then you can open it in the window menu. And look for appearance. First of all, remove the black color on this text so it doesn't affect the effect that we will add to this text. Double-click the characters layer above. Then on the fill layer, click the drop-down menu next to this color box to open the swatches panel. After that, select None, to set this fill layer without color. Click on this top layer to return to the default appearance. And in this panel, we are going to add some effects to get the result which I have shown at the beginning of this video. For the first effect, I'm going to add a horizontal stripe effect to this text. But first, we have to add a layer fill to place the horizontal stripe effect. Click Add New Fill, to add a new fill layer. Here you will find both, a stroke layer and a fill layer. Just ignore this stroke layer because we don't need it, just leave it at none on the color. And what we are going to use, is this fill layer. For the stripes effect we will use a pattern and usually we can access the pattern in the swatches panel, and we will not find the stripe pattern in the default swatches, so we will create it manually. First we will create the base of the stripe, create a long rectangle using the rectangle tool. Click anywhere inside the artboard area to open the rectangle panel. Fill the width with 500 pixels. And height with 5 pixels. Click OK. Next, color this long rectangle with white in the swatches panel that we added earlier. From this long rectangle, we will make the pattern. To create the pattern, you can go directly to the object menu. Pattern. And make. If you find this warning window, just click OK, because this is only a notification window if the pattern we created has been added to the swatches. Now in this pattern option panel, give it a name so we can recognize it in the swatches panel. I named it Stripe Pattern. Increase its height to 12 pixels. Leave the rest by default and click Done at the top on the new pattern bar. Now you can see that the pattern we created is already in the swatches with the name Stripe Pattern. Just delete this long rectangle because we don't need it anymore, so we can focus on this text again. Open the Appearance panel. Select this fill layer. Click the drop-down menu to open the swatches panel, and select the stripe pattern that we just created. Because the editable text effect that we made this time is simpler than the previous tutorials, so we don't need to add too many effects to the layer, while for this fill layer with a strip pattern we don't need to give it any effect. Now we move on to the next step, that is add one more new fill layer, but first, select this character's layer first so that the new fill layer is above it, then click Add New Fill. Click the drop-down menu to replace the color with the color in the swatches, choose the pink color in the color group that we created at the beginning of the video. Once done, add an effect to this layer, but only one effect that is transform effect. Click Add New Effect, Distort and Transform. Transform. Set the horizontal and vertical move to 15 pixels. Leave everything else by default and click OK. We just need to give it a transform effect and we're done with this pink fill layer. Next, add a new stroke layer. First select this character's layer again and then click Add New Stroke. Change the color of this stroke to blue in the color group that we added in the swatches. Increase the stroke to 4 points. We will also add a transform effect to this stroke layer. Add new effect. Distort and transform. Transform. On the horizontal and vertical move, fill it with 30 pixels, twice the move distance on the previous fill layer, so we get the same move distance between layers. Click OK, and we are done with this appearance panel, because the text effect we created is also finished. Now we just need to double-click to change the text. You can see other tutorials about editable text effects on cards in the top corner of this video, or you can click the link in the description. For this simple editable text, you can stop here and just make it as the final result, but I still want to modify it a bit to make it look more dynamic, so I will use the Shear tool in the toolbar. Click and hold this scale tool to reveal the tools that are in it, and this is the Shear tool I'm talking about. It's very easy to use. You just need to click on the end of this text and drag it up or in any direction, like this. You can combine it by pressing and holding the Shift key on the keyboard to get a proportional shape. I think this is enough. Next, I will add a trapezoidal element below this text. Here I only use the pen tool to make it faster. And to give it some color, I used the eyedropper tool and chose the second gradient color in the palette I've prepared, and done. Next, we can add text elements in this trapezium area or other elements as needed. By the way, you can download the I file of this tutorial by using the link in the description so you can learn it, and I hope you can create a better text effect from this tutorial. It's done for this editable text effect tutorial. If this tutorial was useful, you can give a like and please share to your community. Don't forget to press the subscribe button and activate the notification bell if you are new to this channel. Don't hesitate to ask me in the comments. See you in the next tutorial.